Hey guys, how are you? I hope you all are doing good. My name is Fahad and welcome to another video of Get Droid Drums. So today in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can download and install the fully working and fully advanced version of GCam 8.1. As you can see here, you can record the videos even if you have the Redmi Note 8 or device like this and you want to get the slow motion in any GCam, then you just need to install this camera and you will be having that slow motion and portrait, advanced night mode and all other features. So in this video we're gonna review it out and I will also show you how you can download it and install it on your Android device. So without any further ado, let's get started. First of all, you need to download the APK file. How you can download it and install it? Just download the APK file from the link in the description. Just go to the link and just open it up and download the APK file of GCam 8.1. And after downloading it, store it into your internal storage or SD card. Then just click on it and install it like a normal APK file. I just already installed it. And I am going to install it again. So after installing it, just click on open button and here we have the camera. If the camera is not working properly, then you can flash the camera to APK API zip file and you can also download that from the link in the description. So first of all, we have the photo section. From here we have this zoom option to 1x or 2x. And in the settings, we have the flash HDR mode. You can control the HDR right from here. Then we have the Google AWB timer. You can change the screen ratio. Then we have the video option. From here, you can adjust the screen zoom. And you can also use this video stabilization options, which is the advanced options from the Pixel devices. And this feature was missing in few recent updates of GCam, but we have this feature in this version of GCam. As you can see here, the stabilization options, we have the cinematic pan and you can also check its logged active cinematic pan and standard previews right from here, and you can also set them right from here. I'm going with the standard. And in the video, you can enable the flash or you can also disable it. Then you can adjust the screen resolution right from here. Of course, you can record in the 4K ultra high resolution, but you cannot record in 4K with 60 FPS. You only have the 30 FPS. And if you want to record the 60 FPS, you need to move to the full HD 1080p resolution. And in this point you can use the 60 FPS right from here. You can also record the time lapse right from here. You can adjust the time options and you can also record into the slow motion. Here we have the 1x8 and 1x4x. If you want high slow motion, like ultra slow motion, then you need to go with the 1x8x, and if you want normal slow motion, then you can go with the 1x4x. I am very happy with this feature. Like, I am looking for a GCam with the slow motion working and I just get it out. Then in the more options, we have the panorama and photosphere. Then we have the portrait. In the portrait mode, we again have the zoom options right over here. And then we have the flash, screen retouching option, HDR control, Google AWB timer, screen ratio, and at the end we have the night sight. And here we have the astrology mode, like as you can see here. You can set it to auto or you can disable it, and you can set the timer, you can change the screen ratio, you can enable the Google AWB. Now let's dig into the settings of this camera and let's see what we get. And in this camera we get advanced settings. First of all, we have the mode settings. From here you can set the model of your just company of your smartphone. Like I am using the Xiaomi phone, which is the Redmi Note 8, and I just click on Xiaomi. And if you are using the Pixel, you have to select on the Pixel. If you are using Samsung, then you have to click on Samsung. If you are using OnePlus, and you just have to click on OnePlus. So I hope you understand. Then you can adjust its interface, HDR Plus device. I think you should not play with these three buttons. Then we have the JPEG preview format and quality HDR Plus. Click on original for high quality shoots. Then you can enable the GL camera preview, auto NS, enable focus tracking right from here. You can also enable the motion pictures, and you can activate the default astro mode. Then we have some general settings the average Gcam have, like save location, camera sound, Google Lens gestures, social share gestures, device storage. You can also enable it if you are having low device storage in your phone. You can enable it and it will automatically reduce the size of images and videos. So isn't it amazing, awesome? Then we have advanced settings. Here we have show dirty LAN warning, HDR Plus control, RAW Plus JPEG control. Then we have composition. From here you can enable the grid type and framing hints. In the photo you just have to click on full resolution, and in the video section you can enable the video stabilizations. Right from here you can also enable the 4K 60fps. If you want to record the 60fps on 4K, then just enable it, and it only works on few devices. So you can also enable the focus tracking in the video section. So we also have the developer settings, but I am not recommend you, I don't recommend you to use this, because this is only for the developers and senior developers. So I really like this camera and I use it as my daily driver. So hope you guys like this video. If you really like this video, hit the like button, don't forget to subscribe my channel, and the download links is in the description. Go and download and install it, and leave your reviews and questions in the comment section. Subscribe the channel, also press the bell icon for future updates. Peace, thanks for supporting. Okay, bye bye.